Project management success reasons in Australia. The reason investigated by GM Werner and.
And if possible, you know, please go to the middle and present there.
Okay. It is surveyed with the 22 project in Australia, and then this abstract is written. This abstract about the success of the project in Australia. What are the reasons behind this success? Sentence here: the relationship between practices and software project outcomes enable us to investigate why some projects succeed and other fails. This is the aim of the this abstract. 50% of the project begin with unclear requirements. This is very interesting, I think. The success, I think that if any project successful, I think requirements must be clear, I think. To investigate the reasons, Werner and Sherpa prepare a questionnaire. Questionnaire consists of seven sections, indeed. Seven sections, but because of the limitations, we look at only project management requirement and cost and effort estimation and scheduling parts only in the questionnaire. And then this questionnaire given to 42 software companies. These companies are financial institutions, banks, insurance companies, etc. In Sydney, all these companies, and also government companies. And then received completed questionnaires evaluated by Child Square. Questionnaire responses. We received complete questionnaires from 22 Sydney software developers, each reporting on a different software development or maintenance. And also some projects in maintenance, not developing. Majority of our respondents were developers involved financial institutions, banks, and insurance companies and government companies. Result and analysis. The second. Part is the result and analysis. The table from questionnaires M stands for project management questions with prefix M. These questions about only project manager or project management about and. There are 14 questions here, and there are with prefix R requirement about requirement questions, but some of them missing. And with prefix C, cost and estimations about. This question can be
go away.
From the table one, success means successful projects. About percentages, for example, project manager was above the average. In success project, this question yes is answered by 71% and failure
33.
In total, failure all projects. This means in all projects, this question M1 63%. This means all projects. This only successful projects and failure in fail projects. All question is answered and percentages is written here, and then applied chi square to correlation between this question and successful reasons. For example,
you have we have an eraser there if you want to just use it, like eraser, and you don't have to use your
hand. If NS stands for not significant, there is no correlation. This means there is no correlation between this question with success. This correlation is calculated by chi square test variable less than 0.05. If this variable less than 0.05, there is correlation between success project and this question. In result and analysis, for example, the projects our respondents chose to describe 78% were successful. Interesting result here. The percentages of full-time employees on the project median. Do you know median in statistics? 7%. This is very little. In software projects, software project, full-time employees is very low. From our sample in size is quite small, but large enough to gain some useful insights into both Australian software development processes and to identify promising areas for further research. Comment on the relationship between variables. These relationships are significant in a
choice
0.05.
Yes.
Successful. If we look at the questions with prefix M, in the table, we see this fact. This fact means successful project managers are generalists, not technical specialists. While a certain level of technical competence is helpful, managerial and interpersonal skills are more important. Other results support this perspective, since the ability to communication is very important between manager and the other persons, are relate well with staff. Were both positively correlated with project success. This result is important. The one reason is this. And the second one in project management. Project manager rated above average, the question M1, is positively correlated with project success. It is very important, project manager rated average above. This result is not surprising, since poor management can increase. This is also important. If the project manager is poor, that increase the software cost. So the software unsuccessful or fail. An above average project manager, the question again M1, is involved with a good schedule estimation. And good manager means. Good manager means cost estimation is very well defined. So project is successful again. And other result again the tables, the second one. This is also important, I think. Very related with us in the future, I think, if you work any company. Our data supports the view that management support of the development team is essential to motivate the team to work effectively toward the organizational goals as appreciation for working long hours. What positively correlated with project success? Interestingly, the rewards for staff who work long hours was not correlated with the project success. Yeah. Working long hours in the company means the success of the project. This is wrong. Nowadays, for example, government yani şu anda yeni düzenlemede mesela daha fazla insanlar şeyde çalışmayacağına. Yani çalışma sürelerini azaltma yönünde çalışmalar yapılıyor. Bu da bunun bir göstergesi. That's all. The other one, compete with quality. My friend.
So you guys gonna share the talk like half and half?
Yes.
Yeah.
Half and
half.
Yeah.
I will talk about the requirements and effects on project success.
We just have 7 minutes, or let's see. Yeah, like okay, we have time. Okay. 7-8 minutes to make sure. You can press F5, my friend.
I will talk about the effects of gathering good requirements in Australian project development stages. How it affect the results in future. When we say about requirements, expectation, we all know that good requirements leads us to higher likelihood of success. And good project management necessities, that requirements are complete and consistent. In research, we have seen that 71% of our projects respondents did not know what requirement methodology was used to gather the requirements. And the reason is explained in this way, respondents may not have interaction with analysts, they say. It's a weak explanation, I think. They may need to know the requirements gathering methodologies. In the 42 projects, some companies use different methodologies to gather requirements. Some did not, but in none of the projects, UML used to document the requirements. I think it's very interesting. And study shows us in 42 projects in Australia, 52% of projects have started with incomplete requirements. And it continues in the 46 of the projects, scope has increased during the development of the project. This is not a surprising result since we did not get the requirements well, our scope will increase, of course. But requirements increase of the requirements and did not not getting the requirements well is important, but it's not significant success of the projects in the future. And this information shows us. These companies must adopt a software development methodology designed to deal with incomplete requirements. But we see that the Australian companies do not choose the right methodologies to develop their projects. We can ask, does well-defined requirements provide success to our projects? The question was in the questionnaire. Were asked our researcher asked respondents to were requirements completed during the project, and did requirements result in well-defined deliverables? I think these two is connected to each other, and these two is very significant to success of our project in positive way. We can say that. Well-defined requirements will lead us well-defined deliverables. Also, if requirements were initially incomplete, completing the requirements during the project was positively correlated with the project. We also see that from the paper. And if we look in the view of cost and schedule estimation, expectation in reality, good estimates of effort and schedule will affect our project success. But generally, a common problem that is made in the cost and schedule estimation is making optimistic estimations.
Please start.
But our respondents have been asked that did the project have a schedule? And the answer is yes, of course. All of the projects have a schedule. But we can see that it's not significant in our project success. And another question was involvement of the developers in estimating the scheduling and estimation of the costs. And it is also seen that the estimation was not correlated with the project success. It's not a significant feature. And for estimation variables, features, only significant variable, adding the stuff late into to meet an aggressive schedule. This affects our projects, also in development projects, success in a negative way. And other than this, none of the estimation variables were good predictors of our success in projects. Risk assessment and post-mortem reviews. Managing risks throughout the project was not correlated with the project success. We also seen that from the paper and the calculations after this chi square test. And the quality of software project management is characterized by active risk management. We also seen that from lectures that we completed this year. This observation is not supported by a correlation between responses. And risk management also did not affect our success in project management, not our projects, Australian projects. Postmortems are generally conducted at the end of the project process, but also they are useful in the end of the age stage in a multi-phase project. The term postmortem literally means after death. In medicine, the term is used to describe an examination of a dead body in order to discover the cause of death. This means organizations make postmortems to understand what they did good or what they did bad, to see future estimations. Postmortem reviews are important for process improvement, but they are seldom done. And as a result, people who develop the projects tend to repeat some same mistakes on project after project because they see projects are not related to each other. And in this paper, the surveys are based on what software developers say. They took people from companies and asked them what they did. So the results are limited to developers' knowledge. This means we don't know if anything other than is happened at the project or not, we cannot say anything. The developers we surveyed mainly develop in-house software for the organizations. They use this software in their organizations. It cannot be assumed that the results are the same for all Australian organizations, but this data provides some questions for our for further researchers. And in one sixth of our projects, it's found that project manager was effectively shut out of the cost estimation and scheduling process because they were not permitted to negotiate what had been decided by business managers. This may lead the business part of the organizations may lead project managers to fail since decisions are made by the business managers. There is a mismatch between risk identification and control. Most of the project managers identify risks at the beginning of the project, but half of them only use the estimation during the development phase. And organizations that build these projects take projects as a standalone entity. So that postmortem reviews are not perceived as important, and this will lead them to fail in future. Given that over 50% of the successful projects had postmortems, some organizations like to find out what went right during the project and what methods and processes should be used in later. This can increase the success rate of companies if it's used very well. And as a conclusion...
Sorry, folks, I just have to interrupt here, okay? I mean, because of the time. All right.
And these three are decided as best predictors of project success. These three really affects our project success, which are a project manager who has a clear vision of the project and experience, a delivery decision made with appropriate requirements information, and the project that have good requirements, they will lead success to projects.
Sounds good. Thank you very much. I'm going to ask any questions?
What does mean clear vision? What does mean clear vision?
Clear vision, seeing future. How the project occurs in the future, and they will decide what to do.
Estimation.
Not just estimation. Clear vision is coming. He knows what he's doing, right? Project management has a good vision, right? He or she sees the road.
Isn't it about estimation also?
Not just estimation. I mean, vision is a just high level top concept, right? I mean, high level concept. It's not just.
He said experience also.
Vision, right? Vision. What's vision? Means. If you see the future, right? You can follow the right steps to success. So, that kind of thing. It's not just estimation. It's a. I mean, all the activities, right? He can do everything perfectly, essentially. Okay, yeah, I don't have any questions because I congratulate both of you on a good presentation. Yeah, that's a statistical concept, right? No, but the time is limited. We have, again, we are very happy to hear this presentation because, yeah, you guys, so I think, yeah, it's a good example, and I give them 98%. I usually don't give 100. I give them 98%. Means perfect. Yes. Alkışlar.